genes which are present on the wall of the red blood cells or on the wall of the RBCs that is responsible for the differentiation, because these protein could be a glycoprotein or a lipoprotein or such type of the substance which are present over the membrane of the RBC. Because previously, during the last time, we have discussed that how the RBCs are produced, how they carry their functions, what is the normal range that are present in the body, what are the conditions in which their level is exceeded above than the normal limit, and what are the conditions in which the RBCs start to degrade. So that means what we can say, that if later we know that what type of the blood groups are there, it will be easy to transport the or to transfuse the blood from the one human being to the another human being. Because not only the blood transfusion, there is a need to transfuse sometimes the plasma, there is a need to transfuse sometimes the platelets, WBCs is like that. So that means it depends upon the condition that which type of requirement is there for the body. Because suppose I have discussed that if anybody is suffering from any kind of severe infection, that we know that for the infection, there is a ability of the WBC that they can fight against the infectious organs, which could be a different type of bacteria or could be some viruses. So that means the antigen which are, or the proteins or the carbohydrate or the lipids or the glycoproteins which are present on the membrane of the RBCs, they are responsible for the differentiation. Because why it is important to study about the blood group? Because it is not simply the thing that you can transfuse the blood of a one person to the body of another person. So because it is essential to analyze, it is essential to evaluate, to check the type of the blood group, so that we can prevent any kind of the emergency condition, we can prevent any kind of the big instance which could be happen, because this was the problem before the discovery by the Karl Landsteiner. So just I will go to the discovery of one of the big scientists who was responsible for the grouping of the blood, and the grouping he initiated from the animals, because it was found that the mixing of blood and the mixing of the blood was responsible for the clumping or cracking of the RBC's membrane. So that it is one of the property of the red blood cells. So whenever you will mix the blood of two individuals, whenever you will mix the blood of two persons, that is not matched with each other, ultimately such type of problems are being happen. So this scientist whose name is Karl Landsteiner, in 1886 to 1943, he discovered a various type of the blood group and named as a ABO blood group system. Now this Karl Landsteiner discovered that there are presence of blood group A, B and O. Later on, some of the friends, some of the colleagues of this scientist further discovered a AB type of the blood group, or a Bombay type of the blood group, which is called as OH blood group. So this was due to the presence of ABO gene located on the chromosome 9, because a genotype can lead to change in the phenotype. So that means this is the crossing of the gene. So whenever the dominant genes which are present in the body of the male and simultaneously the present in the body of the female, like if there would be a AB, and simultaneously the female will be having a AB. So if we cross this in case of crossing way design, that sometime AA, AB, BB or BA, the chances that the baby may a or a B or AB or BA, the chances that the baby would be having either a A type of blood group or a B type of blood group or a AB type of the blood group. So these are the chances. Later on, after then that, Alexander Wiener, he discovered another factor which is called as a Rh factor. So the name of the Rh factor was the name from the rhesus monkey. So the first time it was found that there is a one of the factor, there is a one of the protein which is present in the blood, and that is responsible for the activation of the immunogenic response, that is responsible for the release of the antibodies in the body of human being if there would be a mismatch between the if there would be a mismatch or if there will be a pregnancy from the parents who didn't having a match of this Rh factor. Suppose if the male is Rh positive and the female is Rh negative and the baby carry Rh positive type of the factor, then there would be a chance that first time the delivery would be possible without any kind of the miss happening, without any kind of the major problem. But the problem is arised during for the second pregnancy, because due to the mismatch of these Rh factor, the antibody would already be present in the body of the female, and that type of the antibody which will be present in the female, they will not be allowed to get the next pregnancy. So what we can say that Rh factor play a big role in case of male and female once they want to get a offspring. So this was also studied by the Alexander scientist from the monkey, and he found that the Rh factor contain some type of the gene like CDE, and D was found to be a more dominant, and D was found to be a more common among the populations. Now due to these discoveries, the scientist this Karl Landsteiner, he got a Nobel Prize in the 1930, and that was due to the discovery of this ABO system. And if I will say that the antigen, that the glycoproteins which are present on the surface of the RBC, which are responsible for the type of the blood group, because if there would be a presence of antigen over the surface of the RBCs with a type of the group, but if there is a no anti-B anti-sera antibody, that means that there will be a chances that person would be a positive, otherwise it would be a B positive, and same vice versa will be there for the B. And there is another type of the category which is called as a O type of blood group. O type of blood group people are universal donor. They can donate their blood to any type of the individual having a blood group of A, B or O. And after then, the AB type of the blood group people are universal recipients. So what I can explain here, that about 55% of the population carry A type of the antigen with a blood group A, and B type of the antigen blood group B, or both type of either A and B over the cellular membrane over the wall of the RBCs. Now, the remaining 45% of the population neither carry A and nor carry B type of the antigen, and they are considered to be having a blood group of O type. So that's why I have discussed that the O type of the blood group peoples are the universal donor. Why I say this thing? Because if O type of the blood group peoples are universal donor, because they did not carry any kind of the antigen, and whenever the blood will be transfused from the one organ, transfused from the one person to the another person, the chances of the blood group reactions are less, because it is equally important whenever we want to infuse a blood from the one body to the another body, it should be done at an equivalent temperature. The temperature changes would not be there. And if you say we transfuse the blood from the donor to recipient, if there will be any kind of the temperature changes, that can lead to severe type of the reactions in the body. Many a times we found that whenever the donor donates the blood, they are donated in term of a bags which carry a weight around 350 grams. Because many a time I ask the question to the student that how much blood we can donate at a time. So what will be the concentration of the blood that we donate? So basically, whenever we donate a blood, it is in term considered as a one bag or a two bag, and if we donate a one bag of the blood to the another person, that would be having a weight of around 350 grams. Now, considering that we cannot or we never be donate the blood beyond our limit, I can say that if a person is too much healthy, and if a person donate a blood of two bag, sometime a problem can be happen in the body of the donor, because a huge amount of donation may delay the process of formations of the new cell if there will be any kind of pathological condition, if there will be any kind of the disease condition. So that's why it is important to know that how much blood we should donate and how much time it is required to the body to reform the new cell, because it is still known to be too less, because if we donate a blood, it can be recovered within 24 hours, but even though recovery depends upon the so many factors, because the blood cells in our body, they are formed by the bone marrow. Suppose if a person is too weak, suppose a person is suffering from diabetes, suppose if a person is suffering from any kind of the disease condition, and bone marrow is unable to form a new cells in a short time, ultimately such type of conditions can lead to some medical problem. So that's why it is too essential for a donor to donate a blood as per the ability of the body, and it is too important for the medical team to know that how much blood we should take from the patient at a time. So that means both are equally important. Now, coming to the another part, that whenever we will infuse a blood which is mismatched with each other, suppose I will give an example here. If we are infusing a blood of a one person, and he or she is donating to the another person, and there is a no matching of the blood group, what can be happen? A serious medical problem may occur. दैट कैन लीड टू द डेथ ऑफ द पर्सन, बिकॉज इफ बाय बाय मिस्टेक वी इन्फ्यूज ए ब्लड ग्रुप विद ए पॉजिटिव टू ए पर्सन हैविंग ए ब्लड ग्रुप ऑफ बी पॉजिटिव, देन द एंटीजन एंटीबॉडी मैकेनिज्म विल बी एक्टिवेटेड एंड दैट एंटीजन एंटीबॉडी मैकेनिज्म वुड बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द सिवियर हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी रिएक्शन एंड ड्यू टू दिस टाइप ऑफ द हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी रिएक्शन समटाइम देर इज ए प्रेजेंस ऑफ चिल्स इन द बॉडी, समटाइम्स देर इज ए पिन प्रिकिंग लाइक साउंड विच मे हैपन फ्रीक्वेंटली इन आवर बॉडी, समटाइम ए क्लोट मे बी फॉर्म, समटाइम द आरबीसी मे बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू क्लम्पिंग फॉर्म एंड दैट कैन चॉक द आर्टरीज, एंड ड्यू टू दिस चॉकिंग ऑफ द आर्टरीज इफ दिस प्रोसेस विल बी हैपन इन द कॉर्नरी आर्टरी दैट कैन लीड्स टू द डैमेज टू द हार्ट बिकॉज देर विल बी ए डेफिशियंट सप्लाई ऑफ द ऑक्सीजन टू द हार्ट. सो इट इज इक्वली इम्पोर्टेंट दैट वी शुड प्रीवियसली रिकॉग्नाइज द टाइप ऑफ द ब्लड एंड द टाइप ऑफ द ब्लड ग्रुप्स whenever we considered that donator is a mutually donating the blood to the person may be his own family member and may be person of somewhere else. So that's why this type of the reaction which is called as agglutination reaction due to the reaction between the agglutinogens and agglutines. That mean the antibodies and the antigen could leads to the clumping of the RBCs. So this was being studied by the scientist Karl Landsteiner, and he found that whenever there will be a such type of reaction between an antibody and an antigen, that can leads to formation of a clump, that can leads to rolling of the RBC, that can leads to damage to the RBC, that can leads to reduce the oxygen carrying capacity of RBC. So these things were being found by the scientist Landsteiner, and after then, according to his law, he also discussed number of things regarding the RH factor, that whenever we adopt a pregnancy, that we should detect whether there will be no any kind of mismatch between the RH factor, because suddenly number of times we found that if there is a mismatch between a RH positive and RH negative person, then there is a big problem to the fetus, then there will be a big problem because the fetus may suffer from the edema-like condition, the fetus may suffer from the jaundice, the fetus may suffer from the carnectivitis, the fetus may suffer from the hypersensitivity problem, and many a times death may happen during the time of the pregnancy. So, considering this, it is essential to find such type of the problem. That's why whenever nowadays we found that there is a mismatch between the RH positive and RH negative, a person can easily analyze their RH positive negative factor by going to the laboratory finding, because a test is conducted for the RH factor, which is called as a RH factor test. By this test, within a few seconds, we can analyze that whether we are RH positive or a RH negative. Now, same previously, I have discussed that the ABO system is one of the big system in which there are around various type of the blood group, and you cannot imagine that more than 12 type of the blood group they are yet known, but the major function of the ABO is well well formulated, well described, as well as well discussed in the available literature. Now, in case of A blood group, if B antigen is absent, then person would be A positive. Then if it is present, then it is found as a then it is present, it is A positive. If it is absent, it is A negative. Simultaneously, if A B positive type of the factor would be there, the blood group would be A P positive, and if no negative would be there, then A B negative. So likely that we can say that there are different type of the blood group which are present among the individuals, which are called as AB positive, AB negative, A positive, A negative, B positive, B negative, O positive, and O negative. Now, the positive group, they are very commonly found, and we can say that they are normally the more positive group lies is around 60 to 65%, but the negative groups are rare. So there is a major problem whenever these people who carry the negative blood group, and if they suffer from any kind of the major infections, it is difficult to donate the blood from the positive, because it would be there that O positive is a universal donor and AB positive is a universal recipient. Now, similarly, I have discussed here that the beta antibody, the B antibody, if it is present, then it is easy to analyze the A blood group, because there is a anti-A and anti-B anti-sera kits which are being used in the laboratory, because whenever you will add a anti-A to the A, it could lead to the clumping of the blood cell. Blood cells get precipitated, and whenever they get precipitated, they can easily be identified. So similarly, anti-B sera would be there, and likely factor D would be there. So these type of the things, these type of the kits, they are very commonly used to find the blood group among the individual, and by this Landsteiner formula, nowadays it is easy to find such type of the blood group. Now, the second thing which is very important, that whenever we will take or receive a blood from the donor, the blood should be preserved at a particular temperature, because even though the blood cells are having a different lifespan, that I have discussed that RBCs can survive for 120 days, WBCs can survive for 20 days, and platelets can survive for 12 days. So instead of this, a blood can be preserved at a temperature that would not be too much freeze, and basically it is kept, we keep it from the you can say away from the high temperature and from the high sunlights or from the such type of the radioactive substances. Now, these blood which are donated by the donor, that have to be analyzed, that have to be evaluated for number of disease, so that unfortunately the disease would not be transferred from the donor to the recipient. Now, in this condition, the tests which are majorly conducted are HIV, and another are hepatitis B, hepatitis C, as well as there is a fourth test which is conducted is syphilis. Now, these four tests are being too much essential, so that we can know that the donor would not be responsible to cause a disease-like condition to the recipient. Now, this would be a too beneficial if we analyze the blood at the time once the donor is donating. Now, see, the blood group depending upon the presence of antigen and antibody, we can easily be analyzed. Suppose a antigen A, which is present over the wall of the RBCs, and there is a anti B antibodies which are rolling or which are roaming around the A antigen. Now, after then, what would be happen as a donor compatible with A and AB? Because AB person can receive a blood from A positive, and it can receive a blood from B positive person. So that's why the compatibility is equally essential to find out to prevent any kind of the mishappening. So they are now, as a recipient, compatible will be A and O, incompatible B and AB, and A makes a anti B antibody. So that means it is essential. Now, next is the B antigen, which is present over the wall of the RBCs, and anti A antibodies, they are roaming around the B antigen. So what compatibility for donor would be there? If they are compatible with the B and AB, and they are incompatible A and O, simultaneously, as a recipient, the compatibility would be for B and O, and it is incompatible A and AB type. Now, similarly, for a blood group AB, the antigen will be present AB, AB, so in an alternative manner, but there will be a no any anti-A or anti-B antibodies. So that's why AB is compatible only, incompatible with AB and O. Now, in case of a recipient, this AB blood group person is a universal recipient. He can receive the blood from A positive person, he can receive the blood from B positive person, he can receive the blood from AB positive person, or he can receive the blood from the O positive person. So that's why this blood group, which is called as AB, which is called as a universal recipient, always having a maximum availability of blood from all the type of blood groups. Now, there is another type of the blood group which is called as O. Now, in this, there is neither A type or nor B type of the antigen present over the wall of the RBC. Now, this type of O blood group is compatible with all the other type of the blood group. So what we can say, the O blood group person is a universal donor. He can donate the blood to a person having a blood group A positive, B positive, and AB positive. So that means the O positive person will be able to donate the blood to the all the other type of the blood group. And if we say what is the compatibility, it will be O only, incompatible if there will be A, A, B, and B type. So this is regarding the type of antigens which are present over the membrane of the RBCs. Now, see how and why they are too important, why it is too essential to find a type of blood group, because it is equally important not only for the recipient, but it is also important for the donor itself. Because if a donor donates the blood, the recipient should be having a matching, and if there would be a no matching, then the serious reaction may be happen that sometime are not be able to control, and that can lead to the death of the population. So this is due to the presence of agglutinogen and agglutins, and both agglutinogen and agglutins, they are responsible for the blood reaction, which is called as agglutination. In the simple term, It is known as a clumping of the blood cells. Now see, the plasma of the AB blood group contain no antibody, so the chances of the reaction are less because only antigen is present on the wall of the RBC, but antibodies are absent. Now, due to the absence of the antibody, the chances are less to become a one of the critical condition. So such type of people, they are known as a universal donor, and opposite for the O are called as a recipient. Now, what type of the transfusion reaction that are commonly happen? The transfusion reaction are a type of adverse reaction which happen if there would be any kind of the error, if there would be any kind of the incompatibility or mismatching. Now, the basic is a type of favor. Now, similarly, I will give one of the example that the Fleming was the first scientist who discovered a penicillin. Now, during the previous time, starting from the 1921-22 till we can say, the penicillin is not compatible for the all. So that's why there is a test which is performed to check the compatibility of the penicillin with the patient. In that, what they do, just they inject a little drop of the penicillin over the superficial layer of the body, and after then they mark over the superficial layer so that if there would be any kind of color change, that if the skin shows a bluish color or a light pink color, then this indicate that the penicillin is not suitable to that patient. So they avoid to inject such type of the drug, such type of the antibiotic, such type of the chemicals to the person because they are not compatible. So similarly here, compatibility is equally important. Now, not only fever, sometimes hives may be there. So hives, they are known as it is a one of the skin problem in which the patient feel a itchy. Sometimes we found that along with the itching, we see that the area of the skin may become red, and due to the presence of this redness, there will be uncomfortability. And once the patient feel uncomfortable, that is a one of the big problem. Now, many a time this incompatibility could leads to a renal failure, and sometimes it could lead to a shock like condition which could be followed by the death. But the major complications which happen after the blood transfusion, they are acute hemolytic transfusion reaction. Because so there are three terms which are very commonly used: either there will be acute, or either there will be a progressive, or either there will be a delayed type. Now, acute means which can easily be controlled and which will happen for a short time. After then, there will be a delayed type of the hemolytic reaction. They not happen very immediately, but they happen after a few hours, few minutes. So these type of these delayed hemolytic transfusion reaction are sometimes to be more serious because they are not easily be observed. So that's why delay in such type of the hemolytic transfusion reaction could lead to death of the person also. Now there will be another type of reaction which is called as a pyrogenic reaction. So basically what we say, the pyrogen are the waste material of the microorganism. Now there is a one of the very common test which is performed for the injectables. In that, what we do, this is still being a one of the good test for the injectable. In that, particularly, we will take a few ml of the drug and then we inject the drug into the air vein of the rabbit. Now, after injecting, what we see, we find any kind of the reaction in the body of the animal. We find any kind of the allergy. We find any increase in the temperature of the body, because these pyrozoans, which are the metabolic waste of the microorganism, they are being analyzed as an antigen by the body, and body produce antibodies against these antigens. So the chances of the hypersensitivity and the allergic reactions are more. Now, not only this, there might be an anaphylactic reaction that would be happened due to the movement of the WBC. So basically, the WBCs are responsible for finding or for fighting against any kind of serious conditions. Now, these reactions, which are called as anaphylaxis sometimes, because due to the movement of the cell from the one area of the body to the another area through a membrane. Another is the transmission of the infectious disease, because these chances are too much, because whenever a one blood group or a blood from a one person is transfused to the another person, if unfortunately the donor was suffering from any kind of severe infection, sometimes these particles, they can be transmitted from the body of the donor to the body of the recipient, and due to this reason, the transmission of the infectious disease from the one person to the another person could be increased. So this is a common condition, but I will discuss here one of the examples, that not only through the blood, a one problem through which whole of the countries in the world, they are being suffered by the problem which was called as a corona problem, which was called as a COVID-19 problem. So what was happened here, just the infection was transmitted from the one person to the another person, either through touch or either through a droplet infection or either by using some of the items which are being used by the infectious patient. Now, the transmission of the infection might be happen through any kind of the route, and that can lead to a serious problem in the body of the recipient. Now, see here, this was the RH system, in which I have discussed that about 85% of the peoples, they are having a RH antigen in their body, and they are known to be RH positive, and they are known to be known as rhesus positive, and do not therefore make the anti-rhesus antibodies. 50% have no rhesus antigen. They are known as RH negative. Now, what would be happen here? I have discussed there the major problem occur during the time of pregnancy, whenever there will be an incompatibility, whenever there will be a no match between the RH positive and RH negative. Suppose if there is a presence of RH negative type of the blood cell in the body of a pregnant woman and baby get a RH positive charge, now the first pregnancy might be happen safely, but the problem occur during the second time. And during the second time, what will happen, that ultimately these negative charge body cells, which are present in the pregnant woman, they are responsible for synthesizing the antibodies, and they would be available for the next type of the you can say pregnancy, and in this case it can lead to the death of the next baby. So this is the RH system, which is very important to play a major role. So in the low, in the you can see here in this, I have mentioned one of the figure that if the red blood cells contain a antigen or a RH antigen, so that means if the antigen along with the RH antigen is present, they are known to be RH positive. And if the antigen of the RH type, Rhesus type, is not present, they are known to be called as a RH negative person. So individually, it doesn't mean that a person will be having a RH antigen will be called as a positive or a negative. It doesn't mean, but if RH is itself present, then they are known to be RH positive. So that's why the laboratory test can easily be useful to predict whether a person is RH positive and a RH negative. Now, there is another topic in which we will discuss about the blood transfusion and what is the role of reticuloendothelial system. Now, a transfusion simply know that it may be the transfer of the whole blood or a blood component. So it depends upon the requirement of the recipient, because I have discussed that if suppose a person body is not able to reproduce RBCs and person is suffering from a severe anemia, person is suffering from a low number of red blood cells, and person body is unable to reproduce these cells, sometimes there is a need to transfuse the whole blood. It is also critically be required in case of a major accidental problem, whenever there is a chances that patient may die due to the severe hypovolemic shock. Now in this case, the transfusion is important, and there is a need to transfer the whole blood from the donor to the recipient. Now another is the transfusion of WBCs in case of dengue infection or some other kind of the bacterial infection. The level of WBC that is too much decline, and if it is declined below than 150,000 millimeter cube of per deciliter of blood, then we consider that the condition is moving toward the critical type of the situation. So in that condition, there is a requirement of the transfusion of WBCs, not no need to transfuse all the other bloods of the cells of the blood. Now, next, the third thing which is required for the clotting that are known as the platelets. Now, platelets can easily also be transfused. Now, the question is, who needs a blood transfusion? People with severe trauma. I have discussed that if there would be a major accident, and after the accident, if a patient lost a big amount of the blood from the body, and a doctor can easily understand that now a heart can stop, now a heart can choke. In that condition, the blood transfusion is required. Now, the second thing, the people's undergoing complex medical surgical procedure. Now, whenever a person undergoes major surgery, or whenever a person undergo multiple surgeries, in that case, the doctor always analyze that now there is a need to transfuse the blood, because during the incision or during the operating procedure or the surgical procedure, there is a maximum loss of blood. So to compensate that amount of the blood, there is a requirement of the blood transfusion. And the third part, which is also important, that the people with a condition such as a thalassemia or a sickle cell anemia. Now that I have already discussed that whenever the RBCs they gain the shape like a sickle, that means whenever the RBCs are unable to gain their flexibility, whenever their shape is fixed and they are unable to transmit to the small blood vessels like arterioles and venules, in this condition there is a need to transfuse the blood. And thalassemia, there is a need to transfuse the blood. Now women with the complications of pregnancy, now this is a big need, because if in the pregnancy the total blood amount is below than 10, then the chances of the complication or the major serious problem may be happen. Because if a pregnant woman had a low level of hemoglobin or had a low level of the RBCs, many a time the heart rate of the baby is increased. Many a time the birth of the baby would be with a fluffy body size and would be having a high body weight. Now these type of conditions many a times happen, and if it happen up to a, if the level of the HB is too much low, and it can lead to the death of the fetus. Now that's why the children with a severe anemia and those resulting from the malaria or malnutrition, they need also a blood transfusion. So for those type of people, there is a requirement to transfuse the blood from the one person to the another person. Now, but I have discussed that we can transfuse the blood easily from the one person to the another person, but the great thing, but the essentiality is to know that there should be a matching compatibility between the blood groups. Because if there will be no compatibility, then the problem, a medical condition can be arised. Now in no these type of condition many a time leads to the death. Now after then, along with the blood group, Rh positive and Rh negative play a equal role, because they also help to produce the antibodies in the body which would be harmful for the baby during the time of the pregnancy. So this is about the blood cells and the Rh factor. Now see here, if a person with a type O blood group is known to be a universal donor, that I have discussed that he can donate the blood either to a blood group of A type, either to a blood group of B type, or either to be a blood group of a person AB type. Now this O type of the universal donor do not contain any type of the A or B anti-antibodies. Now that's why they are known to be universal. After then, AB is a universal recipient, because he can receive the blood from the A or a B as well as AB. So it another condition, what is Rh positive and Rh negative? Now people who have Rh positive blood can receive a Rh positive or a Rh negative blood. So if a person having Rh negative blood, they should only receive Rh negative blood. So now see, when the problem will be there, the problem arises whenever there is a presence of the Rh positive or a protein. Now this leads, if the Rh Negative would be there. Rh negative can receive the blood only from the Rh negative blood donor. So if such type of the person receive a blood from the Rh positive type, then there is a, again emergency condition that can lead to damage to the cells. And whenever you say the RBCs or the red blood cells are damaged, they are unable to carry the oxygen and they are unable to maintain the pH. They are unable to maintain the acid-base balance. They are unable to meet the oxygen demand of the body. And if the oxygen capacity of the body is lower down, there are some vital organs which need a oxygen for 24 hours. Because it is very commonly known and it is a very highlighted thing that what the oxygen we consume daily, out of that, approximate 65 to 70% of the oxygen is being consumed by the brain, because the brain control all the signals of the body and it consumes a maximum energy because it works throughout the life. It works even though in the conscious condition and in case of unconscious condition. Because I always give an example that during the daytime, the blood pressure may slightly be high, but during the night time, the blood pressure moves slightly lower or reduced as compared to daytime of the blood pressure. Because why? During the daytime, the adrenergic system start to go to peak from the early morning to the noon time. So that's why the adrenaline, which is one of the hormone, it is responsible to cause blood vessel constriction depending upon the presence of alpha 1 receptors. Now simultaneously during the night time, we are on the rest and digest condition, and in that condition you can say that rest and digest is performed by our cholinergic system, and that cholinergic system is responsible for the release of acetylcholine, which is known to be one of the neurotransmitter of relaxing type, produce relaxation in the body. Now this neurotransmitter is at the peak level during the night time, and due to this reason the blood pressure of the person is low during the night time as compared to the daytime. So this is the differentiation. Now see, type of the blood transfusion. Now first we will talk about the red blood cells transfusion that I have discussed, that in case of some medical condition there is a need to transfer the RBCs. Suppose if one of the ladies having a pregnancy and having a low level of hemoglobin, then in case of emergency there is a requirement to transfuse the red blood cell so that they can provide the oxygen as per the requirement of the body. Another than that, if a person suffers from a severe anemia, now the condition in which the level of RBCs is moved down or lower down or is not too enough, which is required to meet the demand of the body. Now another thing, if a person suffers from a iron deficiency type of anemia, that means if there would be a deficiency of iron in the body, and due to that deficiency, many a times there would be either pernicious type of the anemia which will happen, because it depends upon the deficiency of type of the iron. That means if there will be deficiency of mineral like iron, then pernicious, then vitamin B12, then megablastic, and simultaneously aplastic type of the anemia would be happen. Now in this condition, there is a required to transfuse the RBCs. Now another, what are known to be a platelets transfusion, if we say that patient is having a low level of clotting factor or not too enough concentration or the amount of the platelets in the body. For example, if a patient suffer from the hemophilia, then that means there is a requirement of the clotting factor, then that means the body of that patient is lacking a clotting factor. Now in that case, there is a need to transfuse the platelets directly to the body of the recipients, or either the hemophilia, which is related to some injury or a trauma or a accidental conditions. Now in specifically how we can analyze in the body, many a times you can say that there is a excessive bleeding from some part of the body, like elbows, sometimes from the lips, sometimes from the ankles, and sometimes from the knee side. Now this type of bleeding is due to the hemophilia, or this type of bleeding is due to the less availability of the clotting factor in our body. Now to compensate this requirement, to improve this particular condition, we transfuse the platelets which are being separated from the whole blood. Now coming to the third part, which is called as a plasma transfusion. So there are so many examples I will give here that why the plasma is required to the body. Because if we say, I have already discussed that the separation of plasma need a use of anticoagulants, that the separation of the plasma could be possible by the use of fluorinated tubes. Nowadays, that are being used in the laboratories, which are known as a fluorinated tube, because the fluorine is having a property to anticoagulate the blood. So that's why the plasma contain two type of the things. One, the constituent present in the plasma are ions, which are called as electrolyte, and the major electrolyte which are present in the form of the ions in the blood are sodium, potassium, calcium, chloride, magnesium, like that. So these are what we can say, these are called as a essential ion, because sodium is responsible for the isotonicity, potassium is responsible along the sodium with isotonicity, calcium is responsible for any kind of contraction, bicarbonate resists the change in pH. No, another are the plasma protein like albumin, globulin, and fibrinogen. These are present in the plasma. So in the current conditions, because just in the last year of 2020, we found that there was a number of deaths we recorded during the corona instance and during the corona type of the pandemic condition. Now why this was happen? Because previously no country in the world was having any type of the toxin, any type of the drug which could be useful to treat the corona infection. Uncertainly nowadays, from the last 20-30 days, some of the drugs which were antiviral, and they are being re-proposed to become anti-COVID drugs, and they are being available to be utilized by the India country itself and some other countries to protect the patient of the corona patient from the infection. But before then, that the plasma therapy was very commonly employed, because it has been found that the plasma transfusion got a great success rate, because while they were taking the plasma, suppose if the one person was suffering from the corona infection, they take the plasma from the dead body of that person. Now what they do, because they know that if a patient is having a capability to fight against this corona infection, that means in the body of that patient there is a presence of some antibodies, and that antibody could fight against the infection if we transfuse the plasma of that patient to the body of the patient who suffered from the corona infection. So that's why the plasma transfusion was required to the patient who suffer from the severe sepsis infection, the patient who suffer from the severe bactericemia, the patient who suffer from the severe bacterial infection. So blood plasma transfusion was being be performed. Now then there is a granulocyte transfusion, because there are two types of the cells which are present in our body. One are known as a granulocyte and another are known as a agranulocyte. The granulocyte, which we have discussed during the previous presentation, that they are the neutrophil, eosinophils and the basophil, and the agranulocytes are the monocytes and the lymphocyte. So what I will discuss here, that the granulocyte which are present in the body, they are particularly of the neutrophil, eosinophil and basophil, and it has been found that if a patient is unable to fight against the serious life-threatening infection, then it would be, or it might be, due to the low level of the granulocyte. Now the transfusion of the granulocyte from the body of the recipient to the donor would make him would make him to fight against the infectious conditions. So that's why the granulocytes play an equi-important role for fighting against the serious life-threatening infections. Now coming to the next system, which is called as a reticuloendothelial system, which is known as a RAS system, because there are two systems. One is called as a RAS, and then RAS. Then RAS means renin angiotensin aldosterone system. It is one of the system which is essential to be regulated in case of severe hypotension. If there will be a positive stimuli to the kidney to release a one of the enzyme which is called as a renin, and that renin help to regulate the conversion of angiotensinogen to angiotensin, followed by angiotensin 1 to 2, followed by 2 to 3, and ultimately it is degraded in the form of a peptide. So this is the another system in which this system contains a special type of the cells who are having a property of engulfment, who are having a property of phagocytosis. So that means phagocytosis is the property of the one cell by which a cell can engulf another type of cell, by which a cell of the body which is called as a macrophage can engulf the foreign particles or the foreign cells, which are called as a debris, which are called as a maybe bacteria, which may be the toxin, or which may be the substance which are antigenic in nature. Now the reticuloendothelial system is a big network of the cells and the tissue, which is distributed throughout the body, and specifically we can say that the reticuloendothelial system, which formed a network in our body like a blood, like a circulatory system, in which our blood frequently distributed or moved from the one area to the another area. So it is also present in the connective tissues, in the spleen or in the liver, in the lungs, in the bone or in the bone marrow and lymph node. Because why I say that it is present, because this reticuloendothelial system help to clear any kind of debris which unfortunately enter in the body, any kind of bacteria which unfortunately enter in our body, or it might be inhaled through the lungs into the body sites. So that's why this is a small system which is responsible for the number of function in our body and is known as a monocyte macrophage cell system. Because monocytes are of two types, either they are being converted into a star cells that are a form of again cells which is having a ability to fight against the immunogenic substances, having the ability to fight against the bacteria. Now see here, in the peripheral site there is a presence of the macrophages, and in the central site there is a presence of a specific type of the cells which are called as a microglial cells. Now what does it mean? It means that whenever there will be an entry of antigen in the CNS, whenever there will be entry of any bacteria in the CNS, or prediction or analysis of any, you can say, infectious agent in the CNS, the microglial cells are activated. And similarly, in the peripherally, there is an activation of the macrophages. Now, these macrophages and are also called as a cleaner system of our body, because they keep our body free from the microorganism. Similarly, a one of the good example which are presence of a Kupffer cells produced in the liver. Now these Kupffer cells, they are having a ability to engulf the toxic material from the liver side, and instead they protect the liver, they keep the liver you can say clean, and they help to decay, they help to damage to such type of the molecules which are being enter unfortunately in the liver. Now there is a one of the another reticuloendothelial system. We can see here that if the reticuloendothelial system does not work properly, so what will be happen? These type of the microorganism can easily be enter into the any organ part of the body, and there they start to grow, and after the growth they will increase the infection, and after then there would be inflammation and progression of the any kind of infectious event, and they can slow down the functioning of the organ of our body. Now the composition of the reticuloendothelial system include the Kupffer cells of the liver and the microglial cells present in the brain, macrophages of the present in the alveoli, and then a bone marrow and a lymph node. Now so that means these type of the cells which help to play a phagocytic role in our body and kill various kind of bacteria and viruses. Now it is important that the Kupffer cells are the protective cells for the liver. They protect the liver and they are beneficial to prevent any kind of the infections which might be happen in the liver by the entry of any microorganism, because liver is one of the essential organ of the body, which play a number of role. Because liver is known to be one of the big gland because of its exocrine and endocrine part. Because liver secrete a bile into the small intestine, and that I have already discussed that bile is responsible for the breakdown of fat. Now, if the bile secretion will be slowed down, if the bile secretion will be less, the fat which we take through the food will not easily be emulsified, and if it not be emulsified, it cannot be digested very easily. So that's why the bile play an important role in our body. Now, this was about the blood group, this was about the blood transfusion, and this I have discussed about the reticuloendothelial system. Now, coming to one of the another system, which is called as a lymphatic system. Now, this lymphatic system is a system of the body in which previously we discussed a blood. It is a connective tissue which flow through a network which are called as a arteries and veins. So similarly, a lymphatic system is constituted of a fluid which is called as a lymph. Now, lymph is different from the blood, because lymph may contain some of the antibodies, or lymphocytes may be present, but the blood contain the proteins as well as the formed element, like all the types of the blood cells. Now, the another question is here, that how we can differentiate between a blood and a lymph. We can differentiate depending upon the color, we can differentiate depending upon the viscosity, we can differentiate depending upon the pH, we can differentiate depending upon the movement. So that's why we can easily differentiate the blood from the lymph. So the lymph, which is a important fluid of the lymphatic system, is a clear fluid, and it always travel like a blood throughout of the body, but blood can travel at a fast speed as compared to the lymph, because blood is pumped by a organ which is called as a heart. But this type of organ is not present in case of lymphatic system. So due to this reason, the lymph always you can say travel from the one organ to the another organ, but at a low speed as compared to the blood. Due to this reason, the lymph always travel depending upon the gravitational forces. The lymph travels along the side of the blood vessels, because whenever there will be a presence of arteries and vein, the lymph vessel will be present along with that. And if the blood help to transfer the blood cells or the oxygen or the nutrient to the different part of the body, similarly, this lymph help to carry some waste material, or help to carry the exudate, has to carry the fluid which is present extracellularly in a large amount. So that means if the lymph contain a lymphocyte, that means there are two types of the lymphocyte. One is called as a B lymphocyte, and another are called as a T lymphocyte. These B lymphocytes help to fight against the infection, and again the T type of the lymphocyte also fight against the infectious organism like the microorganism. So due to this reason, the B lymphocytes are being the produced or be formed from the bone marrow, and T type of the lymphocytes are produced by the thymus gland. So that are both depending upon the reason they are being differentiated. Now the question is here that how the lymph passes through the lymph vessel. Now the lymph passes through the vessel of increasing size and varying number of the lymph nodes. The lymphatic system is consisted of following organs of the body. The organs like lymph, it travels through vessel called as a lymph vessel, and then there is a lymph node, and then there are lymph organs like spleen and thymus gland. Then there is a diffuse lymphoid tissue, that is a tonsil, and then is a bone marrow. So organs of the lymph, which are called as a lymph organs, they are also play a major role in our body. So one by one I will discuss that. Firstly, I will discuss about the lymph. That lymph is a clear watery fluid. That what it means, it is a clear watery fluid. It is the fluid which is likely of blood and is composed of a water. Now it contains some lymphocyte, but exception of the protein which are present in the blood called as a plasma protein. The lymph transport the plasma protein that seep out from the capillary beds back to the bloodstream. So that means only the leaky particles which are moved out from the blood vessels, sometimes that would be carried up by the lymphatic vessel. Now it also carries some of the substance, some of the particles, some of the bacteria, some of the cell debris away from the damaged tissue. So what we can say that this is the lymphatic system is the system which carry the lymphatic organ, which carry the lymph, as well as it can carry some of the organisms or toxins away from the cell. So the lymph contain a lymphocyte that I have already discussed, that which type of the lymphocytes are present. Now in the lymphatic system, the lacteals of the small intestine help for the fat absorption into the lymphatic system. So these lacteals are the small spaces which are present in the ciliar bodies of the small intestine. Their aim is to increase the body surface area. Now see, the lymph which is constituted of a solid and a watery part. Now likely the blood, it is also constituted of 98% of the water, and the lymph is also constituted of a 96% of the water. The organic substances present in the lymph are protein, albumin, globulin, and then clotting factor antibodies and enzymes. The lipids are chylomicrons and lipoproteins. Now here it is important to discuss that whenever there will be an increase in the lipid in our body, what we can say hyperlipidemia, what we can say hypertriglyceridemia, then hypercholesterolemia. In that cases, the lipid will be carried up by the chylomicrons back to the liver side, and they further be degraded to form a small particles, and which can easily be excreted out from the body. So these chylomicrons are important part. After then, glucose would be present, amino acid, and some nitrogenous waste material will be present, which is in the form of a urea and creatinine. Now see here, not only this, the lymph also contains some inorganic substances which are known as a sodium, calcium, potassium chloride and bicarbonate. These type of the ions are present in the as they constitute the inorganic part of the lymph. Now, other than that, the lymphocyte contain other cells which are called as the monocyte and the macrophages and the plasma cells. Now, what are the lymph capillaries? Similarly, like the blood capillaries, if the blood travel through the blood capillaries that are known as arteries, arterioles, veins, and venules, similar like that, the lymph travel through the lymph capillaries and they are called as a lymph vessels. Now, these are the small capillaries which are not be visible to the naked eye, but they are present in the deepest part of the body. So that's why we can easily analyze the arteries, we can easily analyze the veins which are present in the body. So due to their presence at the depth level, they can easily not be located by the naked eye. Now, see here, what type of the lymph capillaries are present. Now, the lymph capillaries, you can imagine now that the arterioles and the venules which are present in our body, they are the lymph capillaries are distributed along the side of the arteries and veins. So, what previously I have discussed, that whenever there will be a leakage from the cells and the tissue level and the fluid is flowing freely, that type of some cells, they are being carried up by our lymphatic system, so that these type of the particle can be drained out or from the body with the help of the lymphatic vessels. Now see here, there is another you can say peak which easily indicate that how the cells and tissue get a lymphatic drainage. Now simply, whenever there would be any exchange of the fluid, any exchange of the ion, any exchange of the protein, any exchange of the nutrient among the cells of the body, equally some of the things are being absorbed by our body and sometimes the remaining is eliminated out and which will be enter in the lymphatic system and it helps to drain out from the body. Because if such type of the toxic metabolites like urea, uric acid, creatinine or some of the other nitrogenous waste, they will not be eliminated, they can start to deposit in any organ or organelle of the body and they can cause any kind of the damage or infection. So due to this reason, the lymphatic system help to drain some of the toxic material out from the body and body cells. Now see here, lymph vessel, the vessel which run, which move along the side of arteries and veins, and they are likely be distributed in the body like a circulatory system. Now, the wall thickness of these lymphatic vessels is likely to be similar to be found in the veins. Now, they are being covered by the fibrous covering and they are being aligned with the elastic type of the tissue. So what it means that our blood vessels are elastic due to the presence of elastic fiber, and similarly our lymphatic vessels are also elastic due to the presence of elastin cartilage which provide elasticity to these organs. Now, like veins, lymph vessels have numerous cup-shaped valves to ensure the lymph flow in a one-way system toward the thorax. Now, after then, I have already discussed that lymph flow is at a slow speed if we compare with the blood, and this is due to the absence of any kind of the pump, because blood is pumped by the heart. So the due to pumping, due to the pressure exerted by the heart, the blood start to move at a high speed. But lymph flow without any kind of this organ, this heart, and but its flow is in a rhythmic way. Its flow is in a continuous way, which is not be disturbed. Now, similarly, from this diagram, it would easily be clear that the lymphatic vessel, they contain internally, they are lined by the endothelial cells. So basically, the important function of the endothelial layer is to secrete a mucus, is to keep the internal layer of the blood vessel being be moisturized, so that there would be a no type of aggressive action of the fluid on the internal wall of the arteries, or wall of the veins, or the wall of the lymphatic vessels. Now, that's why the wall, there is a presence of valves. I have discussed previously that how the veins are differed from the arteries, because the veins contain a valve, but the pressure of the fluid or the blood in the vein is independent of the any heart. So that means the vein blood will never be moved on toward the lower part of the body. Whenever we stand up, due to the presence of valve, they are being closed. And similarly, the lymphatic blood vessels, they also contain a valve. Due to the presence of these valves, there is no back entry of the fluid toward the back direction. Now, sometimes they are called as a semilunar valve. Now, this is about the lymphatic vessels. Now, the important part here are the lymph node. Now, see, node mean a bunch of cell, a group of cell which lie on a one site or a one area. Now, lymph node are oval and bean shape organ, and they are present in the form of a group. Now, the lymph drain through the number of nodes, and that's why you can imagine that lymph node play a number of function in the body. Structurally, if you see here, what is the path of the lymph flow through the lymph node, that firstly there would be a movement of efferent lymphatics, and then there will be a medullary center, which is the innermost area, and then followed by deep cortex, which is then lymph move into the outer cortex, and then it move into the you can say reticular fiber, or then toward the efferent lymphatic system. Now, so this is an important part, that efferent and the efferent. So that help in the movement of the lymphatic fluid. Then we can say what is called as a, what is the structure of a lymph node. Now, the lymph node consists of a reticular and lymphatic tissue, because the lymphocyte are the important defensive cells of the body, because they protect the body against the entry of any harmful substances, or the antigen, or the bacteria. And similarly, the macrophages, which are equally be important, because these macrophages help in the engulfment of the bacteria. this is about the structure of the lymph node. And again, coming to the big two part of the lymph node, one is called as a cortex and other is called as a medulla. Now, basically, this cortex and medulla is present in the kidney, present in the other organ of the body. Cortex is the outer part and medulla is the inner part. Similarly, there is one of the example where the adrenal gland is having a cortex and a medulla part. Cortex secretes some other type of the hormone and medulla secretes some other type of the hormone. Similarly here, depending upon the area, the cortex secrete some lymphocyte and which can further liberate T cells, macrophages, and the medulla is responsible for the release of plasma cells. So this is the big difference between the cortex and the medulla. If we see the structure of the lymph node, there would be entry of fluid from the efferent lymph vessel and it will be moved out from the efferent lymph vessel. Now, internally, the lymph node is constituted, I have discussed already, the internal reticular tissue is present. Instead of that, the cortex medulla part will also be present. So, what are the functions which are played by the lymph? Now, the likely, I have discussed that all the fluid which are present in the body are having their own section. If I will start from the CSF, which is called as a cerebrospinal fluid. That means a word indicates cerebro is cerebrum, and the word indicates spinal means spinal cord. What we can say, the fluid help to move from the spinal cord to the internal cerebrum of the brain. So there is a differentiation of that fluid from the blood, and which is due to the presence of a blood-brain barrier, and that barrier help to protect the entry of the blood cells toward the brain side. Similarly, the another example, if we consider that our eyes contain aqueous and vitreous humor, again they play number of important role in our eyes, and after then followed by, we can say, the presence of synovial fluid in the synovial joints that help in the movements of the joint. Now, similarly like that, the lymphatic system help to play a one major function which is called as a filtration and phagocytosis. Now, what filtration means? Suppose if we will say that the blood help to distribute the required component of the body or the cell, that means they provide oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrients, which are amino acid, ions, sodium, potassium, calcium, like that. So similarly, this lymphatic system help in the filtration. Now, what filtration means? It helps to filter the various organisms. So after then, there is another part which is called as a phagocytosis. Now, phagocytosis means it is the engulfment of the bacteria and it is the engulfment of the virus particle by the phagosomes. Now, what another means? Proliferation of the lymphocyte. Now, similarly, in case of infectious conditions, whenever our one defense part of the body is unable to compensate against the infectious condition, the another type of the cell, they start to proliferate and they start to divide so that they can fight against the harmful infection. infectious agent like the bacteria and like the viruses. Now, due to this reason, the lymphocyte, which are called as a T lymphocyte and B lymphocyte, they start to proliferate, and the proliferation or their release help to protect the body against the harmful conditions due to the entry of the viruses, bacteria, and the toxic particles. Now, the next organ, which is equally important, is called as a spleen. Now, see, the spleen and the pancreas, which are being a well-developed organ and which can easily be differentiated in the human beings, but this spleen as well as the pancreas, they are fused in the small organisms. Like in the rat, if you say the pancreas is fused, so that's why it is not easily to locate the pancreas in the animals like rats. But these organs, which are having a leaf-like structure, can easily be identified. So similarly, this spleen, which is having a dark red color, a organ which is a active organ, and that start to play an important role for the production of the cells in the body and for decaying the cell in the body at the earlier time of the lifespan. What I can say that the spleen is active from the third week of the body. Instead, the spleen is responsible for the productions of RBCs, WBCs, or the platelets, because it is a very commonly known that the spleen will act as a graveyard of the body, because all the RBCs, the WBCs, and platelets, once their lifespan is over, they come to the spleen and they are being degraded. Now, that's why spleen is an important organ of the human body. Now, its color is a purplish and varies in size. Now, its length is 12 cm long and width is 7 cm wide and having a 2.5 cm thick. The weight of the spleen in our body is around 200 grams. So that means there are number of organs which are present in our body with the equivalent weight, describing here about the spleen. So here I have mentioned the sum of the regions that where the spleen is present, and spleen is present in the left hypochondriac part of the body. So see here, I have mentioned all the sites of the body, that where the stomach lie, where the intestine lie, and where the pelvic organs they lie. So that's why this hypochondriac part, where the spleen is present, is also one of the important and essential organ for the body. Now, after then, we come to the structure of the spleen. The spleen structurally is an oval shape like an egg, and we can say its weight and size is approximate to a well-developed egg. And structurally, the spleen is responsible for the release of for the differentiation of the lymphocyte and the macrophages in our body. And the macrophages, which are a type of cell which help to engulf the waste and which help to phagocyte the cells which are not required to the body. So if we say structurally, the spleen is having one splenic artery and one splenic veins and some other lymphatic vessels. So what it means, whether spleen is responsible for the synthesis of the cells in our body at the earlier lifespan, whenever the baby is having an age of around, we can say, 4 or 5 weeks, yet up to the 12 or 15 weeks. Now, the spleen is only one of the functional organs up to that time for the release of RBCs, WBCs, and platelet in our body. Instead of this, after then that, throughout of our life, the spleen help to provide a space for the decay of the cells. What we can say, the RBCs, they are degraded inside the spleen, and the hemoglobin, which is released from the RBCs, the decayed material is called as a bilirubin and a biliverdin. So that's why many a times the people says that we are suffering from the jaundice. That means there will be an extracellular presence of biliverdin, because there are two types of the biliverdin which frequently distribute or transfer through the blood to all the organs of our body. One is called as a conjugated form and another is called as an unconjugated form. The conjugated form of the bilirubin is too much toxic for our body. So that's why after once the birth of the baby, many of the small baby, they suffer from the jaundice. The reason could be number of their reason are the, either the mother was suffering from the low hemoglobin level, either the mother was suffering from the aplastic anemia. So due to this type of condition, the baby after the birth would suffer from the jaundice like problem. But that type of jaundice can easily be recovered in case of small babies if we expose the baby body toward a slightly rising sun. That means whenever the radiation intensity during the morning time is too low, so that the conjugated form of the bilirubin will become unconjugated, and once it will become unconjugated, it will be excreted out from the body and our problem can be solved. So that's why this is a one of the good example which is related to the level of bilirubin in our body. Now coming to the functions of the spleen. The spleen plays a number of functions in our body. The functions are, first function is a phagocytosis. Now what does phagocytosis mean? The phagocytosis means to engulf those particles, to engulf those cells, to engulf those type of the debris material which is not required to the body. So sometime a one phagocyte can engulf to the another phagocyte. This is called as a self phagocytosis mechanism, and due to this reason, not only the phagocyte engulf the harmful particle or the bacteria virus, sometimes they can also eat the essential cells of the body, because after the phagocytosis, the macrophages, they are being burst, and once they are burst, they release some of the lysosomal enzyme. Those type of the lysosomal enzyme can produce a tearing of the normal, you can say, barrier which are present in our body, which are made up of lipids. So because of these lipase enzyme, the lipase enzyme produce a toxic effect. So what we can say toxic, these are only just they lyse the lipids. So next is the immune power. The immune power is produced by the spleen, because spleen not only help to synthesize the cell, spleen not only help to decay the cell, spleen itself help to protect our body against infection. And this is the initial response. Whenever there will be an entry of any kind of antigen or bacteria in our body, the lymphocytes start to divide, they start to proliferate, they start to distribute in our body so that they can neutralize or they can decay or they can get to the exogenous antigen or the other substances. Next, other than that, spleen help to play an important role, which is called as a storage of blood. This particular thing is not completely mentioned in number of books, that our body cells are being desynthesized and then released by the bone marrow, which is present in the large bones, which is present in the vertebra, which is present in the sternum, which is present in the ribs. But being in case of emergency condition, the cells, even though at the age of the adult, they are being released by the spleen. So that's why the spleen is known to be a emergency organ of the body, which can release the cell upon an urgent requirement whenever these type of RBCs, WBCs and platelets are not being formed by our large bone marrows. So another than that, it also help in the process of erythropoiesis. Erythros mean red blood cells and poiesis mean the formation. Now this erythropoiesis only occur in the presence of one of the hormone which is called as a erythropoietin, and erythropoietin is released by the kidney. Now in case of severe hypoxia, what happen? Our body tend to compensate the body requirement, and whenever we move toward the high hilly area, in that condition, what happen? Our body start to produce a more number of RBCs, because if we move to the hilly area, the oxygen requirement would be more and the oxygen level will be declined. In this thing, the erythropoiesis is equally important. So now these are the function of the spleen which I have discussed here. After then, I will now discuss about the thymus gland, that the gland which lie in the upper part of the mediastinum and which secrete a one of the chemical called as a thymosin. Now structurally, this gland is consisted of a two lobes, and the two lobes are joined together by a structure which is called as a fibrous capsule. Now this fibrous capsule help to hold the two lobes together. Now structurally, from this it can easily be understand that how the thymus gland is present in the thorax part of our body. Just it is below to the thyroid gland, and just it is on the both side of the trachea. And now this thymus gland is consisted of a left lobe and a right lobe. Structurally, the left lobe is slightly large and the right lobe is slightly small in size. Now, what again the functions of the thymus gland? The thymus gland help to produce a T type of the lymphocyte. They are known as a lymphocyte, but they only, we say they are T type because they are secreted by the thymus gland. That's why they are known to be called as a T type of the lymphocyte. The thymus gland also secrete a hormone which is called as a thymosin, and which is responsible for the number of functions in our body. Now it is well clear that with increase in the age, the shrinking of the gland is happen, and due to this shrinking, the level of thymosin sometimes be declined with the age. So this only happens once the gland is fully matured, or once we move from the adult age toward the old age. Now there is a one of the malt which is called as a mucosa associated lymphoid tissue. So it is not a malt sugar, it is one of the tissue which is associated to the mucosa. Likely the malt is consisted of two parts, one is the tonsil and another is the lymphoid follicles, and also called as Peyer's patches. The tonsils are located in the mouth, throat, and they are being particularly be present just below to the just above to the larynx voice box. Now sometime due to severe infection and sometime due to the entry of any microorganism or the viruses, the tonsils are being infected and they being swell up, and once they are being swell up, they sometimes create a problem for the swallowing of food. Now this is the major problem, and others are the Peyer patches which are present in the small intestine. And here in the small intestine, what we can say, we always say that the number of microorganisms can cause infection, but you can say malaria, which is one of the disease caused by this malarial parasite, and it can cause or transfer the malaria from the one person to the another person once it bite over the body of the other. But if we eat a malaria mosquito, the malaria would not be happen, because these type of the mosquitoes are being be digested and being be neutralized due to the presence of lymphoid cells and due to the presence of Peyer patches in the small intestine. So what are the major disorders which are related to the lymphatic system? The major are the lymphedema, that means edema of the body due to the obstruction to the flow of the lymph. Now there are two particular major conditions. One is called as a lymphedema and another is called as a filariasis. Now in case of lymphedema, what you can see from the diagram, that one leg is being swell up and another will be a lean. So this is due to the edema. And another condition which is called as a filariasis, here you can see it is again the condition which is caused by due to the bite of a mosquito, and it carry the one of the organism which is responsible for this type of the disease. Now the filariasis and the lymphedema, both the conditions structurally might be shown to similar, but in case of filariasis, what happened, the outer layer of the skin start to become brown and then followed by black color, and ultimately the upper skin area or the upper skin layer sometimes be shrink or sometimes be automatically be torn up. So either due to the lackage of supply of essential nutrients or the blood to the peripheral part of the body. Now there is another infection which is called as a cervical lymphadenitis. Now in this case, sometimes the lymphoid part or the lymph tissue is become swell up, and this swelling of the lymph node or the lymph organ is once we are having a insufficient, we are suffering from deficient power of the immune system, and our immune system is unable to kill the microorganism, and our lymph organs are hyperactivated. So in this condition, such type of the problems are arise, but they can easily be treated by the use of we can say some type of the drugs or some type of the anti-infectious agents. So this is regarding the lymph node. Now this is called as granulomatous lymphadenitis. Now see here, this is also one of the problem which happen in the person whosoever suffer from the severe type of the infection and persistently suffer from these type of the infectious problem. Now in this case, these lymph nodes become swell up, and once they become swell up, the appearance of the globule would happen at the different area of the body. So this is lastly, I will discuss that there is a cancer of the lymphatic system, which is called as a lymph carcinoma. Now, but it is such type of the condition in which the pain is in intolerable, and if the stage of this carcinoma move at the third and fourth stage, that is called as a metastasis, then sometime be unable to control. Whenever it is unable to control, it can lead to the death of the body, because our body will unable to produce a sufficient level of the lymphocyte which can fight against the any type of the infection. So dear all, now in this topic I will just compile up that I have discussed about the blood groups, I have discussed how we can transfuse the blood, I have discussed what is reticular endothelial system, I have discussed what is a lymphatic system, what are lymphatic organ, and what are their functions. So you all are welcome for any kind of questions. So thank you for the patience and listening me on this particular topic of human anatomy and physiology.
So good morning, everyone.
Good morning. So, welcome.